Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Doctor, thanks for being with us again.
Hey, good morning.
Let's start with this. There's been a lot of talk on whether pregnant women should get this vaccine, but now there's proof that if they get it early in the pregnancy, it's even better.
Yeah, well, it's early in the third trimester at this particular point. But what they're saying is the women mount a great antibody response, and the baby actually gets those antibodies. So that's an advantage to the baby, and we don't know, that probably stays for many months in that infant. The largest study to date actually is just 28 women. That's the biggest one, and that was done at Northwestern.
And we just mentioned about the Pfizer vaccine, some good news with that as far as how long the effects from it will last. Also, AstraZeneca, which has been in the news for all kinds of issues, it sounds like we might not even need the AstraZeneca vaccine now.
Yeah, Marcus, that's good points. Let's start with the good news. The Pfizer vaccine, they've basically done everything right. The thing works much better than anybody expected. They did an 800 people in their 30,000 person or 40,000 person study were in South Africa. So they have data on the variant down there that is a very nasty one, the B1351. And no matter where they did this thing, it worked. They have protective antibodies. They work against this particular variant. Everything went well. AstraZeneca, on the other hand, has had a very shaky rollout. The vaccine does work. It is safe in the U.S. study anyway, but I mean, they've made so many missteps. And today or yesterday, Dr. Fauci even said, we may not even actually need that vaccine, which is, kind of telling.
News that vaccinated people actually do not transmit COVID-19. Now, am I getting that right? So if you have the vaccine, you don't wear a mask, or is that a step too far?
Robin, this is huge. It's coming from the CDC. They're saying, by the way, when you get a vaccine, it works like every other vaccine. You don't get the disease and you don't spread the disease. Okay, this makes sense. Now they have proven it. So this means you can increase your little health bubbles of people, your family, your friends. If everybody's vaccinated, hey, it's kind of normal.
I feel like that's brand new information.
If you're vaccinated, that's a different story. But in your group, if everyone's vaccinated, you're, good to go.
All right, let's take some questions here. If someone had a Moderna vaccine but then was able to get a Johnson & Johnson vaccine 28 days later, what would happen? Could that provide excellent full-range coverage, or would there be some type of dangerous immune system reaction?
Well, first of all, there would be nothing dangerous that would happen. However, you may take away from the benefit of having two Moderna vaccines, which we know is incredibly effective. So, why risk it? Why play around and do your own one-person experiment? They tested these vaccines by themselves, and they work by themselves. Let's not design a program of your own.
Yeah. All right, next question. I would like to know when homebound people are going to get vaccines. I don't hear anybody addressing this issue.
This is an issue because it requires someone going to each person's house. It has been addressed, but we need to see the results of this. The Johnson & Johnson vaccine would be perfect for this because you only have to have one visit. You give the person the J&J vaccine, and then they never have to come back, and they're vaccinated. So, but this is a public health issue. You've got to deal in the city with, you'd have to ask Dr. R. Woody. And if you're outside of the city of Chicago, Dr. Ezekiel, because this is a public health issue. And that has to be addressed by the public health people. And they have to assign somebody to do this vaccination.
And another question here. I did not have any side effects from my Johnson & Johnson shot, not even a sore arm. Is that normal? I think a lot of people are wondering, if I don't have side effects, is the vaccine working?
Yeah, this is a very common question. I don't have any side effects. I feel fine. It didn't work. No, it worked great. There is absolutely no correlation between side effects and efficacy of the vaccines. The vaccines work over 90, 95%. I mean, this is incredible, incredibly successful. Most people do not have side effects. That's great. Have a great day. Tell everybody else to come in and get vaccinated because, over half the people have almost no side effects.
I feel like we're ending the week on a positive note. Yeah. I like that, Dr. Murphy.
Hey, happy Easter.
Yeah. If you have a question for the doctor, you can post it on our Morning News Facebook page. We'll talk to him again at this time on Monday. Have a good weekend.
Thanks, doctor.
Okay, have a great weekend.